I remember flipping straight to the comics page in the paper, but now thanks to cost cutting, some of Australia's longest running comic strips have been killed off, leaving the artists who drew them wondering, what do we do now? Previously, the biggest metropolitan papers in Australia got to choose what made up their comics page. Now, News Corp have decided to save money and run one national page, and local comic strips Beyond the Black Stump, Swamp and Staria, which has been running since the 80s, have been cut.
The newspapers have been struggling for a while. You know, their rivers of gold have dried up, so they're looking to cut costs, and every time newspapers look to cut costs, they look to the comics page. The question of, do people even want comics anymore? I think it answers itself. People want comics, because there's web comics. Back when people had a daily newspaper, an afternoon and a morning newspaper, they would read the comics and go, oh my God, that's exactly, I do that. Or, oh my God, my kid does that, or my dog does that. Now we have memes, you know, and comics are the exact same thing. Only they take a little bit longer to draw. That gap between the panels, where there's a blank space, and you get to decide what happened between that panel and that panel, that's the connection, because it's different for everyone. And so it's not just kids, it's everyone who has that connection with comics.
Expensive, locally produced comics have been replaced by cheap syndications from overseas.
The value of local content seems to be completely ignored. And that's not to say that it's their fault that they can't afford it. It's just a real shame that that's happened, because they're extraordinary strips and they're being produced right here in Australia, and less people get to see them now, less Australians get to see them now.
David Blumenstein is one of the founding members of Squishface Studio, Australia's first open comic studio. Here, seven local artists work collaboratively, run classes and teach workshops.
I don't think that there is an Australian comics industry. Nobody in Australia that I know of is making enough money off just drawing whatever comics they want or publishing their own comics.
David's creation, The Adventures of Brett Braddock, found success online.
That was a lot of fun for me, and I made no money off it and I didn't care. I just wanted to do it and it was fun. There's fewer and fewer newspaper strips, and fewer and fewer, you know, people who can do that sort of thing.
Syndication is a very 20th century way to make money as a cartoonist. It means you get paid for every strip that gets published. The 21st century way of getting paid as a cartoonist tends to be to publish, gather a big following, and then sell merchandise.
Ben is the only person in the studio who's actually supporting himself off of comics. He actually does a regular strip for a men's magazine. Probably some of the best cartoonists in Australia have at some time been supported by doing filthy cartoons. Nobody prints cartoons anymore, but they still do. Because I guess they figure, you know, truckers like cartoons, and so they should, and so should everyone, but these ones have tits in them.
So how do we get a generation who has always got things for free on the internet to pay for it?
I feel like The print era for Australian comic strips is over. It's coming to an end. But there's a whole new life beginning for Australian comic strips. It's something that I can see a new golden age for cartoons on the internet. The Australian comic strip has always punched well above its weight. Australian comic strips get syndicated around the world. Ginger Meeks goes to 34 countries. Being as young as I am, and probably one of the youngest working cartoonists in Australia, I have to err on the side of positivity and optimism. So I would say that the only way really to predict the future is to create it and try things. Just try things. So I try everything with cartoons, and hopefully something sticks.